For the longest time in my business, I struggled with content creation. I wasn't publishing blog posts regularly. I wasn't publishing emails regularly. I didn't have a process in place that allowed me to do this. That was the main point. And today in this video, I want to walk you through my process of publishing 3 weekly newsletters and converting 2 of them into blog posts consistently for the past 5 weeks using a combination of Notion and WordPress. So with that, let's dive into Notion and let us look at the list directly. So there are 3 phases in my process. The first one, what we are looking at right now, is collecting ideas in this email newsletters phase. Then the second one is actually creating the content. And the third phase is repurposing and distribution. So in this newsletter list, as you can see, it is a very simple view inside Notion. And all I do, let me zoom in a little bit here. All I do is whenever I have an idea throughout the day that I think is worth sharing, I just write it down into this list. So for example, I have all the emails until December 18th scheduled. Now, those are Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. So the next Monday would be the 21st. And for example, what I would just do is 21st video about content creation in Notion. And then in this outline, before I'm even setting aside the time to write the content, I would just jot down some notes here. So for example, share the link to the YouTube video, explain the pain point of not creating content consistently, and share results of sending email newsletters 3x a week. So for example, this is my ideation phase, if you want. So whenever I have an idea, I just jump into Notion and I jot it down as an email newsletter. And those emails, they don't need to be extensive because nobody has time to read 1,000 words in an email. When you look at emails, for example, this mental deload week, it is a rather short one. It's maybe 300 to 400 words, which you can write easily. Usually it takes me around 30 minutes right now to write email newsletters for the entire week. And that is because I have the topics down already. So this Notion page is open whenever I am on the computer, whenever I'm working. And then when I have conversations, for example, or when I have, when I'm coming across good content that I think is worth sharing, like the Gutenberg Times live Q&A that's starting on December 10th, which by the way, you should attend at 2:30 PM Eastern time on 7:30 PM UTC, because it's about making an open source story with Yoast. So this is my process for ideation. I just write down notes. I got this idea to have this constant note-taking habit from Davinder Singh Kane, who is a friend of mine, also spoke at the WP Agency Summit, and he sends out multiple weekly newsletters. And when I asked him how he did that, his response was very simple. He just said that he always takes notes of the good stuff he comes across throughout work and then curates those into newsletters. And I've adopted that because I'm not sharing a curation newsletter. I'm not sharing just curated content. I'm always telling a little story in my email newsletters. So I have adopted this note-taking habit to just take notes on what I think is worth writing a short story about when I come across something interesting in my day-to-day business. So this is writing the emails. As you can see, for example, let's look at this one. When life takes over, become a stoic. This is going out December 11th. I have all the content in here, all the story that I want to share, and I just copy and paste that into ActiveCampaign, which is my main tool for sending the newsletter. So I would just copy this entire text into the clipboard, go to ActiveCampaign, and I would create a new email newsletter for this. So obviously I'm not going to show you the the internals of my ActiveCampaign, but you get the idea. I would just copy that into the into a new campaign and schedule it for the day that it's set to go out on the Notion document right here. Now, as I've mentioned in the beginning, this is not just about email newsletters, but about content repurposing. So the first phase is ideation, which is just jotting down ideas in a list. It's not more than that. The second phase is content creation, which is setting aside. I usually on Mondays set aside 1 hour to write 3 newsletters, and that can be for a couple of weeks in advance. So as you can see, I have newsletters scheduled now until December 21st, which is a couple of weeks in advance. It's 20 days from now at the time of the recording. So this gives me the flexibility to not worry about the newsletters for the foreseeable future, which is very, very important. You always want to have content going out, even if you cannot create content for like a week, because life happens. That's just how it is. Now, what we also can talk about is the repurposing process. So I do have this workflow, publishing a blog post from Notion, which is for my virtual assistant, Irish, and she is going through this process. I'll share it with you below the video. You can see the link to this document below the video and use it for yourself, really. But all she does is she knows exactly how to repurpose the content. And the beauty of collaborating in Notion or Google Doc would serve as well for this matter is that she can add her feedback and adapt the process as she finds need for it. So for example, point 4, use Grammarly to check for spelling and grammar errors. That is something that I didn't have in there that she brought up, because inside Notion, Grammarly is not working. Inside WordPress, it is. That makes a lot of sense to use Grammarly then, because I'm not a native English speaker, so I do have spelling and grammar errors, and Grammarly helps avoid these. And this is the power of a collaborative platform. So that is why I opted for Notion rather than having everything inside a notepad. You could also, for example, with the newsletter ideas, there's no need for Notion at this point. You can always have the notepad file open and jot down ideas in notepad and then write directly in your email marketing program. But with Notion, having everything in one place just makes things a lot easier. That is, and the free plan of Notion, by the way, serves perfectly for this purpose. Now, what Irish is then doing after I tell her which newsletters to repurpose into blog posts, she goes into the WP Agency Summit and creates a post. This one, for example, let me bring them side by side, is how to provide 24/7 maintenance as a freelancer repurpose into blog posts. So her process involves copying the headline, copying the content, doing a little bit of SEO research, and then using Yoast for optimization, for keyword optimization. So this is, let me just clean that up real quick. So in the process, in the document that I've shared below the video, you can see the entire process. And what we do is we use this blog article or this email newsletter as a basis for the blog article. So this email newsletter has like 400 words, maybe 500. And then you can expand these really easily. So now the article has almost 1300 words, which is obviously more important for SEO to have a little bit longer articles. And by having the structure outlined already, it is very, very easy. You just add some headlines to segment the text, which Yoast is telling you to do anyways, to not have paragraphs with more than 300 words without separating them with subheadlines. And then you just expand on the topic and deliver more information. You can add more links to it. You can refer to other blog posts that you have written on your page. And it probably takes me by now maybe 20 to 30 minutes per blog article to finish up what Irish has prepared. That is why it's very important to have a VA. Obviously, it would take longer if I would have to go through the entire process myself. And then probably at some point you can even hire freelance writers to write the entire content for you based on the email newsletter. But at this point right now for me, I still prefer the personality inside the contents, and that is why I'm writing all the contents myself. But with this process, ideation, email newsletter creation and then repurposing and promotion on the blog and social media, obviously, it is very, very easy to stay on top of my content. So this is really all there is to it. There's no magic, no silver bullet. It's just plain execution of a process. I always have Notion open. That's the biggest one. Whenever I'm on a call or something like that, I have Notion open on a separate window. And then I would just jot down into Notion what we are talking about, if it's something that can be shared. For example, this Gutenberg Times was from a conversation with Birgit Pauli-Haag, who's running the Q&A. The e-commerce growth formula is based on a webinar that we did with Cloudways with this guy. The name escaped me, but it was last week, and I link it in that email, obviously, where we talked about conversion rate optimization for e-commerce growth and getting your analytics, getting your data right for e-commerce growth, which is very, very important, obviously. And then when you have the basis, when you have the ideas and the broad topics that you want to write about, you just need to set aside 30 minutes to an hour once a week to write all the content and to schedule all the content to go out automatically. And then when you have the content in email form and you have the content written, it is very straightforward to just expand them into a more complete blog posts, maybe expand them to 1,000-1,500 words, something like this, deliver more information on your blog. And the way I keep people interested on being on my newsletter is a time delay. So it usually is 2 to 3 weeks before an email newsletter goes public onto the blog. And by expanding on the topic, I even can deliver value to the email subscribers who already read the email, because they get additional information, they get additional links and resources they can check out. So that always keeps the subscribers happy. And to share some results of sending 3 newsletters a week, the open rates went up and the interaction rate went up too. And I keep hearing that people appreciate the newsletter, which is something that is really new to me, because for the past 5 or 6 years, I never managed to send out a newsletter consistently. So this is a very, very rewarding feeling. And you just train people to expect your email, to expect you in their inbox. That is all what's most important for me, is I want people to expect me showing up in their inbox, to know that they will learn something on that, or that they'll at least read a somewhat reasonably well-written story in my email newsletters. And that is how you train people to watch out for your emails. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you being here. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel. If you want to learn more content like this on how you can promote your agency or your freelance business, how you can elevate your marketing to the next level, then definitely subscribe, hit the like button, and leave a comment on whether you found this content creation process helpful or not. Thank you so much for watching.